this is like my first big time bartending job. Before this, I was a bartender for 5 years in college. And it's not a thing, man. Like, really, this is tough. The beauty industry is a whole nother world. So kudos to y'all for doing this. This is hardcore, for sure. Okay, and then upkeep, scheduling, and then at the end of the day, almost take PT, not take marketing so seriously. Social media is fake, very fake. So just make sure to like not put yourself down every time you see something. So upkeep. This is just scheduling. Like I said, business, Facebook Business Suite is the way to go. You can link your Instagram to the Facebook Business Suite so you can just schedule one time and it'll post on both Facebook and Instagram. It's really easy. And then you'll just go to publishing tools and schedule posts and create posts. Later on, I will have a class on how to actually do like all this stuff. Because if this is something that you're really interested in, I want you all to succeed. So definitely come to me. I'm going to have classes on this for you. Because this is like the whole, I got a degree in this. You all are just getting like a snippet. So definitely come to me if you have any questions, and I will have classes on those for you. And then there are other great scheduling programs. We got Hootsuite, Preview, and Wix. Hootsuite is pretty cool. I liked it. I used Hootsuite in college. We had a lot of like our classes on there. I think I have a capstone on there. It's really hard. But it's easy to use on your schedule. Searching like how to do this or how to do that in the marketing industry. HubSpot's good. YouTube's for sure. It's awesome. I use YouTube all throughout college. It's great. Udemy, which is good as well. AppH, blogs in general, and it's your best friend. Google is awesome. But yeah, I honestly use all of these during college because college is a scam. I'm sure you hear that every single day. It's a good waste of money, but if you get a degree, you get a piece of paper that says you can do what you know. $30,000 piece of paper. It's cool. But I definitely recommend using these, and they all be perfect. It's super easy. Marketing is common sense. It's a whole other world for sure, but at the end of the day, I suppose getting through the overflow, growing through so much here, spreading what you do to the world. So, yeah.
chose, say, my friends list, and it's the same four people that's like it. So I'm gonna do that. It looks like it's set up correctly.
You're doing it on the desktop, correct? Doing it on desktop? Okay. And then, this is Facebook Business Suite, right?
Yeah.
Okay. How many? You have more than four followers, right?
Correct.
Okay, so I don't know why I said that. I'll take a look at it though for you. And I'll figure it out if you have not done that. Normally with Business Suite, you should be able to schedule your post so that all of your friends can see it. And everybody who follows you can see it. Okay. So I do have a survey for y'all to fill out. I'm doing a project. I need to see how y'all look.
Yes. I have a question.
Yes.
So when it comes to logos, do you have any preference on like your face being on your logo, or do you just say keep it, you know, simple, classy, my preference, what I want to do? What do you suggest?
So that's a great question. I do not recommend putting your face on a logo, but I do recommend putting your name on the logo. And like a symbol that kind of signifies it. If you do put your face on the logo, it just makes the logo seem too busy with all the colors and all like the, you know, the
effects
and stuff. So definitely just do like a, not a basic logo, but something that's very pleasing to the eye and something that your viewers are going to want to see. I know. There are some people who create like cartoon logos. I'm sure you've seen those. Those are super cool if that's what you want to do. The cartoon logo. Did that answer your question?
Yes, it did. I do have another question as well, and thank you for answering that one. My second one would be, I don't know if anyone else on, who's listening have done it and can give any kind of insight, or if you can give any insight on the boost on Facebook. Does that work because you actually pay for it? And when they're boosting it, are they sending it to everyone in your area, like all of your friends on your Facebook page? Because I really want to keep my Facebook friends away from my business page. So when it comes to... And I simply say that because I'm in different states and different mind frames. Do you know anything about the groups?
Yes. So the Facebook groups are, like you said, paid for. But whenever you set up these Facebook groups, you can set up a radius. So in that radius, you can target the different locations that you want to target. So if you want to target a different city or like numerous cities, then you can put that in the radius so that only those people can see it. Each price varies, so if you do like $5, you only get a certain amount of views or engagement on Facebook. So I definitely recommend like probably paying $10 to $20 for each boost. But with that radius, that's going to help your followers not see your business stuff. So if you want to keep them both separated, use that radius, and it should pop up whenever you're about to like pay for it.
All right, Shelby, thank you.
You're very welcome. Okay, does anybody else have any more questions? No? Okay. So, this is a survey that I would like y'all to fill out. On the survey, I think there's two. On the survey, it'll ask just basic information, yes, I do want to try to come in here.
My name is Chico.